All right, shalom. It's been a while. It's been a while since we do this, at least in English. All right. This is, I am Wyndham, brother to some, Raz to others, Alonso to Ferry, reporting for the Lion of Judah Society. In most cases, LJ Society Español or Issachar. In this case, it is what it is. LOJ Society. All right, let's see. Today is July 11th, 2016. It's 1:24 a.m. Let's see. The world is the world. All people don't have to be a part of the world. But how could we? How could we reach such a conclusion, lest it be first proposed? Do black lives matter? Do black lives matter? Life has to matter first. The solution to all these problems is very simple. Very simple. One black life matters. One black life matters. This whole gun killing, blah, blah, blah. We don't get it. That's a thing. It's a God problem. Cops don't have anything to do with it. Environment don't have anything to do with it. Each and every one of us as individuals has everything to do with it. The solution is the first power of the Trinity. As I would say in the Amharic Edamawi, Haile Selassie. What does that mean? Edom or Kedem in the Hebrew. The earliest, way before, ever since we can remember, the first. Since we can remember. Haile, power, strength, might. Let's see. In the Hebrew, we could make that relate that to El. Example, Elohim, El Shaddai, El Chayil, the power that be. Selassie, Selus, Selassa, or no, not Selassa, but I think it's Selus in the Hebrew. Three, the third. The power of the Trinity that's been since since ever since always. What does that have to do with salvation? What does that have to do with violence, war, with black lives? The original man is a black man. We fell. Now we don't see, now we don't hear, now we don't taste, now we don't feel. And what we do see, hear, taste, feel is it just isn't the fullness of it. As a matter of fact, it's the deceit of it. It's the confusion of it. As soon as we raise or are raised, better yet, to man's original state, then everything changes automatically. No more persecution, no more death, no more lies, no more difficulties, because then we would live where we belong in heaven. Yeah, we'd be here on earth, but creation itself cannot harm who has been placed over it. All of creation is to minister to man. It's only for our joy and entertainment. But we don't know that. So we see everything that is contrary to our own good. And until we ascend as man created in the image and in the likeness of the Creator, until we become or stand from whence we fell, nothing will change anything. As a matter of fact, things will get worse. So the solution is accepting one black life, because one black life matters. I assure everyone, without a doubt, that if one's focused their attention, their energy, and give themselves to making a matter of this one black life, everything will change. One black life matters. Why only one? Because all of us is dead, straight up. That's the deceit of the matter. Thinking to be alive, because we do feel, we do see, we do hear, we're dead. Now, recognizing that would be first step. Then we must die a second death. Death to self. Death to the fact that I don't like that this individual is saying that one black life matters, and I definitely do not like that he's saying that matters, because I hate myself, because I hate the one man that will change everything. Straight up, it's just what it is, because it's a God problem, because we refuse to accept that he is true and that his Bible, his word, is fulfilled from beginning to end, the end revealed from the beginning. We refuse to accept that Ethiopia has anything to do with the Bible when it has everything to do with the Bible. We refuse to accept that the Bible's even true, because it's not a black, white, green, pink matter. It's a individual hatred towards our Creator. We refuse to accept that he is true. I ain't even talking about behavior. I'm not asking anyone to keep no Shabbat, to do this kind of ritual, this kind of tradition, whatever. No, it's just for the own consciousness sake, which cannot lie before its creator, to give a true and faithful witness. The necessity is to do it now, and to get rid of me, the self, that's imposing or preventing us from just accepting him, because he matters. And if you accept that he matters, and you learn about him, and you study about him, and you dedicate or livicate rather at that point your life to him, then you yourself will matter, and everything that surrounds you, you will affect and contaminate with life, because one life matters. The first power of the Trinity matters, because that's the gateway to the state of man before the fall, when we can see the things not seen, hear the things not heard, interpret the things to which there is no written or preordained solution to. We would have attained the answers to questions that have never even been asked. We would have reached the things that are impossible, so-called, to reach. But we must enter into minimum the third power of creation, because the way we see things is 2D. So there's nothing behind that wall, because I can't see it. That's the attitude. You're stuck in 2D. You can only see destruction, because that's where that's going to lead to. Plain, flat, 2D non-existence. That's not even the world we live in. You should know that, because you can't see through that wall. You should know that that's no excuse for you to pretend that there's nothing behind that wall. Because you so-called don't see God, so-called, because even that's a straight-up lie, then you can't accept that he's true, because we dead. Now the third power isn't the end. It's the beginning to life. Life more abundantly. One black life matters. Focus on that black life, and all life will matter. Now, what about Yeshua HaMashiach, our black Lord and Savior? Does he matter? Yes, he does. But that part of the scripture has been fulfilled. That was all right for some time. It's not enough no more. How many people believe in Jesus Christ and nothing changes? That, you know, there's times allotted for different things. That time is over. Now, Christ must be resurrected in each and every one of us. But how can that be if we don't have a father to resurrect them? It's Edamawi Khelselasi who will resurrect the true and living Christ, our black Lord and Savior, without a doubt. Because we will see him in and through him. Because we are one. It's that simple. Nobody knows the Son because we have not accepted the now revealed Father. And those of us that have seen the Father, lest the Son reveal him to us, having seen him, we don't see him. So I go to Haile Selassie first, and he says, "You must follow Jesus Christ." I don't like that. Well, that's the King of Kings of Ethiopia. If I say he's God, then I got to listen. All right, open up the Bible, start reading. To my surprise, wow, this is true. So what does the Son say? My Father's God. Son, the Father sent me to serve the Son, and through the Son, I can see the Father in fullness. First power of the Trinity, one black life matters. Care about him, everything will change. It's basically what it comes down to. Now, Yeshua HaMashiach, black Lord and Savior, he'll give salvation to a very personal, individual extent. He brings salvation to the nations at the highest position in human government. Is whence he operated upon this earth. So if we all want to get out of this mess, then we have to, you know, just accept that he is who he is. One black life matters. If we accept that one black life, then all black lives, without a doubt, do matter, have mattered. But we must live to even be matter. Don't they call this like matter or whatever? Like physical matter? You don't matter unless you're living. And you ain't living unless you're in the spirit of life. And you haven't received it unless you've been granted it. And how could it be granted you? Unless you be chosen. So, you know, I mean, I ain't trying to pressure no one. I mean, you know, it. Just putting the word out, one black life matters, you know. Germawik In him is Christ Jesus, Yeshua through the Holy Spirit. And he will resurrect us from this death. You know, so one black life matters. Haile Selassie first. And it's the one black life that everybody just refuses to even look into because he doesn't matter to most of us. We don't care about him. We rather lie and deceive ourselves, pretending that purchasing guns is going to change anything. Pretending that, you know, just acting like fools is going to change anything. It's a God problem. All we got to do is accept that, oh wow, look, just like in the Bible, this is true. My behavior is just as bad as many. But my words and my testimony is true and faithful. Not that I am true and faithful. He is true and faithful, and the book is fulfilled. Behold, the lion of the tribe of Judah, root of David, has prevailed to open the book and to loose the seven seals thereof. And in the midst of him that sits upon the throne of great King David, through Solomon and Sheba, established in Ethiopia, in his midst, in his heart, is the one black life that'll resurrect life itself and each and every one of us. Because the lamb was slaughtered, but it's in the heart of the Father, and the lion prevail triumphant to rid us of sin. We ain't trying to go into like details that would take a lifetime and then some to testify to. But consider, if you really think that black lives matter, why does this one black life not matter to nobody? Why does the one black life that has been placed, granted, whether we like it or not, has been granted the highest, most respected, most honorable seat, position, status, merit by God, by the grace and mercy of the Almighty God, has given one black life that, and it's the one, the same black life that we refuse to accept, and it's the only one that matters. And until it does, all other lives automatically in him and through him already matter. But matter is physical existence, so we must be physically alive to even be considered as matter. Do we matter? Are we matter? It'll matter when we put our minds to the proper matter, the one black man that matters. The one that has liberated us to the extent that we have been able to receive the representation of God on earth. The one true and faithful witness to the Son as the Son is to the Father. So let's just because I know I gotta do some teachings on in Spanish. We'd love to do this more often, but we have a choice to make. We got to bring forth the teachings to those that haven't received them. We would have expected that there's enough of us in that speak English so that a lot of these things already would have been expressed, but that doesn't seem to be the case. So, what can we do? Here's how we're gonna end it. This is pretty much as simple as it can get. That's the one black life that matters. That's the Father. This is Earth. Flames, destruction, chaos, fear. That's the dragon eating up the earth. We don't have to be there. This is cops shooting black people. And black people shooting black people. And black people hating black people. But it's not even about that. It's not even about black and white hating each other or this or that. It's about we all have one thing in common. We hate him because he represents the truth. So what do we do? Well, the Son, whom the Father is in his heart, has extended his arms, and you see, let's see, and he will draw us out of this earth so that we dwell with him in heaven, even on earth. You notice how the original black man and woman, you see how we ain't got no clothes? That's because we ain't covered. We ain't got no covering, so cops can shoot. It's that simple. See, if you're a friend of God's, nothing can happen to you. Doesn't matter. But that's impossible to believe, right? No, it's not. It's very simple and it's very true. Just like nothing could harm him, no one takes his life, he give it up, he lay it down for us. We'll let go of the pride, let go of the prejudice, let go of the racism, black or white, it doesn't matter. We all hate Ethiopia and we hate His Majesty. So it's not a color thing, it's a God thing. And he will take us, save us from this. Now, in his image and to his likeness, same thing. But this time, we have now the Father declare it, and very, very plainly, Christ is in his heart, as in the other depiction or representation. The Father was in the heart of the Son. In this case, the Son is in the heart of the Father, because we are one. Same thing, except in this case, we added some tombs here, some graves, because that's where we at. You know, we adorn ourselves thinking we look pretty, but we just covering up the fact that we rotten dead inside, because we hate the only black life that matters. So it's as simple as we can put it. I mean, who can receive it? Well, Jah decide, you know, but at least we try. All I'm saying is just study. I ain't asking no one to believe anything. Just study the one black life that'll matter. And you'll see how fast your life and all the lives, black or white, around you will change. It's a God problem. He who is friends with God, and more than just friends, is sons of God. Then you are God. No one can touch you. So, one black life matters. When do you think that consequences began to afflict the, you know, for lack of a better term, the racist white, you know, supremacy community? When the one black life that is to declare redemption, the year of Jubilee, release, punishment over, 400 years have passed. Now, black lives matter, but only in him. What did the leaders of the world think? Ah, what is it that the last African nation get plundered, raped, and murdered? They just black people. Mm-mm. Because this black people matters. Because this man matters. Little did they know that this time, unlike the last 2,000 years, there would be consequences. Why? Because one black life matters. This man right here. Today will be us. Tomorrow, it will be you. 1936, Geneva, Switzerland. Everyone, who's gonna? We're white. We're superior. It's just another black nation. So what if the Vatican takes Ethiopia? What difference does it make? Mm-mm. Things change because this one black life matters. 5 years to the very day, Ethiopian Independence Day. Then proceeded the bloodiest phase of what, you know, we could refer to as D-Day, Destruction Day, or the Day of Vengeance of the Lord, because tomorrow it shall be you. And then, you know, phase two, destruction to the European nations. And from then on, black lives have begun to matter, but then we forgot that he's the only one that matters. And as long as he's in our heart, then we matter. And nothing can touch us. As soon as we forget about the one life that matters, in whom is Christ Jesus, in whom we should be one, until we return to whence we came, if we came from whence we seek to return, then we shall be, because we have been and ever will be. Nothing can ever change that, but except that we refuse the one black life that matters. It's that simple. But like I said, it has nothing to do with color, with lives. It has everything to do. We just don't want to accept that God is true. That's what it comes down to. One black life matters. Haile Selassie first. In him is Yeshua HaMashiach, our Black Lord and Savior. In him, all things are granted us according to his word. Life more abundantly. Then people won't shoot at us. Because then we become sons of him who hath called us to that honor. That honor cannot be taken of one's own will, lest he first be called. This day thou art my son in whom I am well pleased. That day could be any day that you decide that he matters. All right, so, shalom.